Hey everyone! Welcome to day 4 of the 15-day songwriting challenge. Today we're going to be talking about rhyming and rhyme schemes. If you're new here, be sure to subscribe and download the free template down below to help get you started with writing. If you're a patron, then you can download the extra templates and resources over there as well. So rhyming is really important when it comes to writing lyrics. It's one of the things that distinguishes lyrics from poetry. There's a lot of similarities, but with poetry, your reader can see the ends of the phrases, the ends of the paragraphs. They can see the structure while they're reading it. But with lyrics, your listener needs to be able to hear the structure. So rhyming lets your listener hear the ends of the phrases, and a lack of a rhyme also tells the listener when the song is going to continue. So really, it's a way to help orient your listener, and also it helps give your song structure. Then rhyming is also a way to make your lyrics more memorable. So for example, if you take that phrase, "You snooze, you lose," that's something that rhymes and it's something that people say a lot. But if you changed it to not rhyme and it's "you snooze, you miss out," it really doesn't have the same effect and it's not as memorable. So rhyming is important for that reason as well, and it's especially useful in your choruses, which should be the most memorable part of your song. So we're going to talk about a couple different types of rhymes. The first type of rhyme is a perfect rhyme, and this is when the two words have the exact same vowel sound and they have the same ending. So an example would be day and way, because they have the same vowel sound and they have the same ending. And then another type of rhyme is a near rhyme, and this is when the words are close to rhyming but not exactly. So you can have the same vowel sound, but you would have a different ending of the words. So an example of that would be day and wait, because they have the same vowel sound, but they have a different ending. Then another type of near rhyme is when you have similar vowel sounds and then the same endings. So an example would be dock and luck. They have similar vowel sounds with ah and and then the endings are the same with that K sound. So a really good resource for finding rhymes is rhymezone.com. You can go there and search for any word at all and find perfect rhymes and near rhymes for that word. So now I'm going to tell you about some popular rhyme schemes. Each one has 4 lines of text, and we're going to use letter names to show where the rhymes would be. So the first rhyme scheme is AABB. So the first line rhymes with the second line, and the third line rhymes with the fourth line. This is a really nice and tidy rhyme scheme. Each phrase is going to sound closed, and it's really good for choruses because you have the rhymes coming at a faster rate. Then another popular rhyme scheme is ABAB. So now line 1 rhymes with line 3, and line 2 with line 4. And then at the end of line 2, it's going to feel incomplete. So at the end of line 3 and line 4, then it's going to sound nice and closed again. Then another popular rhyme scheme is ABCB. So now line 1 and line 3 don't have a rhyme, but line 2 and line 4 do have a rhyme. So this kind of rhyme scheme is going to give you a little more freedom with the lyrics because you don't have to worry about rhyming as often. Also, it gives you a little more freedom if you're struggling to find a rhyme, because you could potentially just switch the lines around and see if a different line is easier to rhyme than the one that you were trying to rhyme. And then the fourth rhyme scheme I want to share with you is AAAA. So in this rhyme scheme, every single line rhymes. So you want to end with a word that has a lot of potential rhymes, and a good vowel sound for that might be A, because then you've got day, pay, may, say, or ooh, because you have you, do, to, and moo. So rhyming will oftentimes feel a little bit like a word puzzle, because the process of it, you sometimes have to work backwards. So let's say you wrote your first line, and you have the last word of the first line, then your next step usually is to find 4 or 5 rhymes for that last word. Then after you have those rhymes, you try to think of the second line, something that ends with that rhyme but also makes sense with what you already wrote in the first line. So in this way, it can be kind of a fun and sometimes frustrating puzzle. So if you find yourself struggling to find a rhyme with something that you've written, there are a couple of things you can do to kind of troubleshoot the process. The first thing you can try is looking up that word that you're trying to rhyme in the thesaurus and see if there are some better options, some words that still make sense with what you're saying but have more potential rhymes. So for example, one time I was writing a song and I was trying to rhyme the word meadow, and there really weren't many options for that word, so I looked it up and I found the word field, and that had a few more options that I could work with. Then another thing you could try is just rearranging that line, see if you can end with a different word instead. And if that doesn't work, then you might just have to come up with a different phrase. So your assignment today is to pick one or two of your favorite lines from what you wrote yesterday and then create a four-line phrase out of it with one of these rhyme schemes. You might have enough material to write the four lines from that, or you might have to come up with a few new ideas. So be sure to download the free template below to help get you started, and if you're on Patreon, you can use those extra templates and resources over there. Let us know in the comments which rhyme scheme you're gonna use, and if you want, you can even share what you've written. So thank you for watching. Please like the video and subscribe, and I'll see you tomorrow. We're gonna talk about song form. See you then. Bye.